Hey, what's up everyone? Welcome to my YouTube channel, Life Science with KMD. Today I'm going to explain about adenovirus as a vector. Adenovirus are the first DNA virus which has been isolated from adenoidal tissue in 1953. Approximately 100 serotype have been recognized, at least 47 of which is able to infect the humans, subdivided into 6 subgroups based on hemagglutinization, that is from A to F. Human pathogen belong to 49 serotype. Common serotype are from 1 to 8, 11, 21, 35, 37 and 40. Adenovirus structure. This is the adenovirus structure. It is a non-enveloped DNA virus, icosa delta hedron, and structure is of icosa delta hedron, and it consists of a size of 70 to 90 nanometer. It is a linear double-stranded DNA genome which consists of 36 kb base pairs and with a terminal protein of molecular mass of 55 kilodalton. The capside comprises of 240 capsomer, which consists of a hexon and a pentone. Now there are 12 pentons, have a pentone base and a fiber. The fiber, which is a viral attachment protein, can act as a hemagglutinin. The pentone base and the fiber are toxic to the cell, carry type specific antigens. Adsorption and entry into the host cell. The entry of adenovirus into the host cell involves two steps of interaction between the virus and the host cell. The Coxsackie virus adenome virus receptor, which is also called as CAR protein. It is a specialized motif of pentone base protein interact with the intrin molecule which is present in the receptor. The attachment to the cell surface receptor is done through this receptor, and the receptor mediated endocytosis will take place, which led to the entry into the host cell. Entry of the nuclear material inside the host cell. Now this is the modified gene, modified DNA injected into the vector. This is the new gene, whereas this is the viral DNA. Now the vector binds to the cell membrane. Vector is packaged into the vesicle. The vesicle breakdown release the vector. Now this vector inject new gene into the nucleus. The cell makes protein using new genes. So this way the gene therapy using an adenovirus will be done. This is the genome organization of virus. Now this adenovirus replication is a two-phase event. It consists of a early and a late that occur before and after DNA replication respectively. So in case of, this is the E1A gene which involved in the replication of the virus, whereas E3 gene involved in the modulation and the immune response of the infected cell, whereas this E2B gene involved in machinery of viral DNA replication and ensuring the transcript of late gene. E4 gene is involved in metabolism of virus mRNA and provide the function that promote viral DNA replication and shut off the host protein synthesis. Importance of sequential gene expression. Now the proteins which are produced by the gene E4 and E3 has three major role. The protein produced by E4 alter the expression of host protein that is necessary for DNA synthesis, and even it will activate other virus gene such as virus encoded DNA polymerase. Now the protein which is coded by E3 gene avoid the premature death of the infected cell by immune response, whereas this site helps in packing packaging signal. This is called IR is called as an inverted repeat, which is present at both end of the linear double-stranded DNA. Now coming to the construction of recombinant adenovirus, this is the genome of adenovirus. AD is adenovirus. So the genome of adenovirus consists of all the genes like E1, E2B, E2A, E3 and E4. All the genes are present in the adenovirus. Now to construct the recombinant adenovirus, in the first generation, what they have done is that they deleted the E1 region encoding product. Next, in the second generation, here also they have deleted the E2 or E4 region along with E1 region. So in the second generation, along with E1, E2 or E4 region has been deleted. Now in the second generation, they have produced a gutless vector, or it is also called as a helper dependent adenovirus, which contain only the cis acting terminal repeat and a packaging signal. So this is called as a gutless vector, which is produced in the third generation. Now this adenovirus has been used in gene therapy work. For that, what they will do is that first the gene of our interest has to be amplified in the P shuttle 2 vector. Here the gene of interest will be cloned in the multiple cloning site, will be inserted in the multiple cloning site, and this gene will be amplified in the host cell, that is in the bacteria. Later, from P shuttle 2 vector, the gene of interest will be isolated by using double digestion restriction enzyme, and then this gene will be added with the, now this gene of interest will be inserted into a BD adeno X viral DNA. After that, inserted into that, and ligation will be done using SWA-S1 digestion, and then it is transformed into E. coli for amplification. Later the purify the recombinant BD adeno X viral DNA, then it is digested with PAC-1 digestion to linearize the gene of our interest. Then that gene will be transfected to the HEK293 cell line, that is 293 cell line, which is a human embryo kidney cell line. After that, we can collect the recombinant adenovirus. Now, how to generate a gutless adenovirus? For that, we require helper adenovirus genome and a gutless adenovirus genome. Now this helper adenovirus genome consists of an inverted terminal repeat on both the site and a cis terminal repeat, as well as LOX-V sequence. Along with it, it consists of an adenovirus genome. Whereas the gutless adenovirus genome consists of an inverted terminal repeat on both the sites, cis terminal repeat, and a human stuffed DNA, that means gene of our interest. Now these two genomes are co-transfected into the CRE293 cell line. Once they enter inside the host cell, both will start to amplify its genome, where the gutless adenovirus consists of a gene of our interest, but it doesn't have a gene for the synthesis of protein, viral protein codes. So what happens, it will multiply its DNA, but it will take the viral protein from helper adenovirus genome. This helper adenovirus will provide the viral protein. So this helper adenovirus consists of a cry recombinase, which will bind to the LOX-P sequence in the genome, and it will cut the DNA. So only the viral protein can be synthesized. The DNA amplification of the helper adenovirus will be restricted through this process. So this gutless adenogenome will package its DNA into the viral protein of helper adenovirus gene produced from the helper adenovirus and start producing gutless adenovirus. Only there will be, if there is a contamination, if at all the helper adenovirus able to put its DNA inside the viral protein, it is like a contamination, it will be up to only 1.1 to 10% only, but the 90 to 99.9% purity of the gutless vector can be synthesized through this process. Now the Cre recombinase, a naturally occurring site-specific recombinase of bacteriophage B1, recognize the 32 base pair sequence named LOXP. The Cre can be efficiently mediate site-specific recombination using two LOXP sites separated by a sequence of variable length. The recombination event include deletion, insertion, inversion of the sequence of LOXP site. Advantages of adenovirus. Adenovirus can infect dividing as well as quiescent cell with equally high efficiency. Adenovirus is ubiquitous. It has been isolated from large number of different species with over 100 known stereotypes. Can rapidly infect large range of human cells. Low pathogenicity in humans. Can hold large segment of DNA. Genome does not undergo rearrangement at high rate. DNA is easily manipulate with current recombinant DNA techniques. Disadvantages. Host immune system plays a pivotal role in adenovirus mediated gene transfer. Short-term expression, particularly in dividing cells. Limited transduction of cells with reduction or no expression of attachment and internalization of receptor. Transient expression of foreign genes. These are the disadvantages of adenovirus. Thanks for watching my video. Please subscribe to my channel by clicking on subscription button. Subscription doesn't cost you any money. To get a notification, click on a bell icon. Do like and share this video with friends and family. If you have any kind of feedback, do share it on a comment box. Thank you.